Hi, my name is Mariel, and I'm with Colorado State University Extension. I work with Denver 4-H and we do youth development programs all throughout the city and county of Denver. For more information on our office and programs, visit us online or through our social media. Now let's get started on today's activity. Shaving cream rain clouds. What you'll need is some water, a couple small cups, a vase or cup, make sure that it's made out of glass and see-through so that you can watch the experiment. Shaving cream and a couple different colors of food coloring and either a droplet or I'm using a fourth of a teaspoon. Let's get started with the activity. First, I'm gonna take my three cups and fill them with a little bit of water. This is going to be used to make our color mixtures. I'm going to pour a couple drops of my food coloring in each. I'm using red, blue, and green. Gonna give them a little stir. And then once you're done with that, put them aside. Now we're gonna take our vase or cup and pour some water, but make sure you leave a couple inches from the rim. That's where your shaving cream cloud is gonna go. So the water represents the atmosphere or the air around us. Next, take your shaving cream, shake it up, and pour a thin layer around the top. I'm gonna make mine about 1 or 2 inches. If it's too thick, it's gonna take a while for the color to fall. This part can get kind of messy. Next, take your colors and just start putting them on the top. And we're gonna watch and see what happens. So the shaving cream represents the cloud, and you can see the streaks are coming down, and that's like the rain streaks you see. So let's talk about the science. Again, the water represents the atmosphere or the air around us, and the shaving cream are the clouds. Clouds are made of water and moisture. The food coloring represents water. As the clouds get saturated with more and more moisture, the heavier they get until they reach a saturation point where they can't hold any more water in them, and then they release it, which happens in the form of rain. Now it's time to be a scientist and ask a couple questions and make observations. How many droplets did it take before you started seeing the food coloring rain? What do the clouds look like when it's raining? Sometimes they get dark and are a different color. Next time it's raining, go outside and look up. What do you see and observe?
Thanks for joining us. I hope you had fun. For more activities and resources, follow us on social media. I'll see you next time.